Nvidia just released 340 billion parameter model called Nemotron-4. And it's not just a single model, but a family of three models. That is Nemotron-4 Base, Instruct and Reward model. The really interesting thing is that Nvidia is releasing these models under an open license. This means researchers and developers can modify, build and use these models freely. Along with the three models, Nvidia also released their synthetic data generation pipeline, using which they trained their Instruct model with 98% synthetically generated data, and also the code repository Nemo-aligner, using which they trained these models. It's a big deal in the AI world, where companies like OpenAI are not so open and keep their models closed under an API wrapper. In this video, I'm going to break down about these models, the synthetic data generation pipeline, and why this is such a huge news for democratizing AI development. If you're new here, hello, my name is Anubhav. I have been working as an applied scientist at Amazon from past 4 years. And on this channel, I share latest news about AI development, dive deep into the technology and life as a scientist. So if you would like to see more such content, make sure to subscribe. Okay, so to understand why there are three models in the Nemotron-4 family, let me first walk you through the process of how large language models like GPT-4, Claude 3.5, and Gemini 1.5 Pro are trained. A conversational large language model training requires three steps, which is pre-training, supervised fine-tuning, and model alignment. As you can see in the diagram, to create the base model, we first use low-quality data but in large quantity, in trillions of tokens quantity, which is data such as the internet data, which is used in the language modeling task to create a base model. This base model is then fine-tuned on high-quality data, which might not be in as much abundance, but is required to fine-tune the model in improving its quality of generation task. So in this case, they use high quality data of fine-tuned for dialogue, which is then used for supervised fine-tuning task and create a SFT model. The number of prompt and responses are typically in the range of 10,000 to 100K responses. This supervised fine-tuned model is then aligned on human preferences. For this, we use human annotators and get the output predictions to compare which output predictions are good versus bad. The data is then used to be classified, and this classification is used to train a reward model. The reward model essentially understands the preferences of what the humans like versus don't like. This reward model is then used along with the supervised fine-tuned model to label and annotate large amount of data and get feedback, similar to how humans would have given the feedback of liking versus not liking an output. Using which we then finally get the instruction fine-tuned model. Using a reward model makes the whole process inexpensive and can generate large amount of comparison data to fine-tune the model for conversational aspects. Nvidia has released all three models as presented in this process, that is the base model, the reward model, and the final instruction-tuned model as well. Now let's talk about the performance and how good these models actually are. From their technical report on Nemotron-4, we can see that the base model was trained on 9 trillion tokens. To give you a comparison, Llama 2 family was trained with 2 trillion tokens, whereas Llama 3 family was trained with 15 million tokens, and ChatGPT was supposed to be trained on allegedly 13 trillion tokens. What they show in terms of comparison is that Nemotron-4 base model is able to outperform open source models such as Llama 3, Mixtral and Qwen on benchmarks such as MMLU, Big Bench Hard and Arc Challenge. Similarly, the Instruct model also is able to outperform these open source models. While this may not be as impressive because of the large size of Nemotron-4 with 340 billion parameters in comparison to these smaller 70 billion plus parameter models, what is amazing is the part that the model was trained with 98% synthetically generated training data. Even more amazing is the fact that Nemotron-4 reward model outperforms the proprietary models such as Gemini 1.5 Pro and GPT-4o. As you can see from their blog, the Nemotron-4 reward model takes in a text prompt as input and returns a list of floating point numbers that are associated with 5 attributes from their HelpSteer 2 dataset. The reward model leads the reward benchmark with an overall score of 92. What they also mention is that Nemotron 4 has a significant lead in chat hard examples, which is a subset of test dataset that evaluates a reward model's ability to understand trick questions and subtly different instructions responses. Along with these models, Nvidia also released HelpSteer 2 dataset, which was used to fine-tune the reward model. It has 10,000 different prompts with their responses, each of which is evaluated on 5 different attributes, which is helpfulness, correctness, coherence, complexity, and verbosity. They use the HelpSteer 2 dataset to fine-tune the Nemotron 4 base model using the Nemo-aligner repository to get the reward model. What they mention is that unlike the binary preference-based methods, the STEER-LM reward model training process allows the model to provide more expressive feedback on the 5 parameters, whereas the binary trained reward models might sometimes conflate a long response with a good response. If you've liked the video so far, please like and subscribe to the channel. It really helps out the channel and helps more people discover such content. Now let's talk about how you can use these models to fine-tune your own large language models. Nvidia also released a synthetic data generation flow, which can be used to fine-tune your own large language models. As you can see from the flow diagram, the developer can specify the domain-specific input query, which can be passed to the instruction model to create synthetic data. This synthetic data can then be used by the Nemotron reward model to identify which of the responses and prompts are good versus bad. This filtration helps in identifying quality dataset, which can then be used to finally fine-tune your own language model. Nvidia has also released Nemo-aligner, which is an efficient toolkit for model alignment, which can be used to train your own reward models and align the instruct models using techniques like RLHF and DPO. In a case study, they used their synthetic data generation pipeline to create 100K samples conversational synthetic data called Daring Anteater, which was then used to fine-tune Llama 370 billion base model, and it was found to over-exceed or match the performance of Llama 370 billion instruct model on a number of standard benchmarks. This was achieved despite using only 1% of human annotated data that Llama 370B instruct model was trained with. This will democratize large language model training for people who do not have access to high quality human annotated data. This move by Nvidia will make powerful large language models and training tools accessible to a wider range of researchers and developers across the world. If you found this video helpful and want to stay up to date with latest AI technology, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Drop your thoughts and questions in the comments below. I would love to hear your take on Nvidia's open approach and how this will impact the AI landscape. Stay curious and keep innovating. This is Anubhav, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.